know there's been a library here since at least Anglo-Saxon times, and Alcuin, whose statue is outside, was one of the early librarians until he was poached by Charlemagne to go off to the continent and do wonderful things over there. But when he was here, he really built the library up. And we know the sort of wonderful things he had because he left a poem in which he listed all the books that he had here. And there was kind of things you'd expect, like the works of the church fathers and Bibles and prayer books. But there was also history books and that sort of thing. After Alcuin, the library really went into a very fallow period until about 1414, when a man called John Newton left his collection of manuscripts. And at the same time, they decided to build a new library, which is where the Minster shop is now. And that was the library at the top and the school underneath. So it was a real educational establishment. And it's the first purpose-built medieval library in the country. Since then, the library's gone from strength to strength. And it is really now a series of collections. One of the largest came from Toby Matthews, who was one of the 17th century archbishops of York. And he had a collection of 3,000 books, which at the time was a big collection. We also have books from Ferdinand of Fairfax, who was one of the Fairfax family. He was one of Cromwell's parliamentarian generals. And he left some really interesting books. He was a lawyer and a soldier, but he was obviously interested in medicine, so he left us a really nice collection of medical books. And then a man called Marmaduke Fothergill left his collection of books. He was an interesting character. He believed in rolling around in the snow naked to stay healthy, and in fact lived to be quite an old man, so it obviously works. Our last collection came in 1890, and that was from a man called Edward Hailstone, who was a lawyer over in Bradford. And he collected books on local history. It was all of Yorkshire history. And he was really concerned about where these books should end up, where they'd be safe. And he didn't want them to go to a public library. He did not see the point of public libraries at all. He didn't understand why would he have wonderful books and then let people actually use them. And he described public libraries as spoilators of books. Anyway, in the end, he did a deal with the Minster, and his collection came here, which we're really lucky to have. But although he didn't value public libraries, luckily our attitude today is very different, and wonderful initiatives like World Book Day are really helping to promote libraries and literacy and reading and the love and joy of books.